गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द प्रैक्टिकल्स ऑफ द केमिस्ट्री। आई ऑलरेडी शेयर दिस पीडीएफ ऑन द ग्रुप, यू कैन यू हैव सीन आई थिंक सो। देयर आर द सिक्स एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑफ द केमिस्ट्री वन। माइसेल्फ एंड श्वेप सर आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑफ द पेपर वन। देयर आर द सिक्स एक्सपेरिमेंट, आउट ऑफ दिस थ्री एक्सपेरिमेंट आई विल एक्सप्लेन and the three experiment, remaining three experiment will explain by the Shoaib sir. Today we are going to see the experiment number one, that is to prepare the 0.1 normal succinic acid and standardize the NaOH solution of two different concentrations. Why this succinic acid has been chosen? The succinic acid is used as a primary standard. Primary standard is nothing but a chemical which is readily available in the pure form, and it should not be either hygroscopic or say fluorescent, and its solution should be stable for the considerable period of the time, and succinic acid satisfies all these parameters, hence can be used as primary standard. Sodium hydroxide is a hygroscopic and the exact weighing is not possible, hence it is treated as the secondary standard and used. And it is used in liquid oblique solution form, and it can be standardized again the primary standard that involves the acid base reaction. In the 12th, you already perform the acid base titration. Similarly, we have to perform the acid base titration because succinic acid is the acid, NaOH is the base. You can see the reaction between this particular succinic acid and the NaOH, where the H plus ions of the succinic acid react with the OH minus ions of the NaOH. You can see the succinic acid CH2COH, CH2COH plus twice NaOH gives you the CH2COONa, CH2COONa plus twice H2O. You can see 2H plus plus 2H minus will gives you the formation of the two water molecule. What are the required things here? The two different concentration of the NaOH has been provided to you, approximately 0.08 and 0.1 normal NaOH. We have to standardize that solution. Then succinic acid in the solid form, air graded, it is given. Phenolphthalein indicator, 100 cm cube standard measuring flask, burette, distilled water, then 10 cm cube and 25 cm cube pipettes, 100 cm cube beaker, 150 cm cube conical flask, etc. These are the things required for the experiment. Now we will see the procedure. What is the procedure involved in this particular experiment? You can see in the preparation, in the procedure, first part is the preparation of the standard succinic acid solution. We have to prepare 100 cm cube of the 0.01 normal succinic acid. We have to weigh 0.59 gram of the succinic acid, and we have to dissolve it in the 100 cm cube of the distilled water in a standard measuring flask. It will give you the 0.1 normal, that particular succinic acid. Then we have to standardize it. First of all, we will standardize the one solution, then we will standardize the another solution of the NaOH. We have to fill the burette with the supplied NaOH solution that may be of the different concentration, 0.08 or 0.1 or say 0.05 may be there, like that, depends. Okay, pipette out the 10 cm cube of the 0.1 normal succinic acid solution in the conical flask, and we have to add the phenolphthalein indicator to that solution. We have to shake it, then we have to titrate it against the supplied NaOH solution from the burette. End point will be from the colorless to the pink. That will be the first reading. Then you have to take the second part, 0.1 normal solution we have to take. Then what will be the reaction? Reaction already we have seen. Observation for the part 1. You have to write the observation for the part 1. Solution in the burette, 0.08 normal NaOH solution. Solution in the conical flask, what we have pipetted, 10 cm cube of the succinic acid plus indicator. What was the indicator? 1% phenolphthalein solution. Then end point will be the from colorless to pink. Okay, you got this particular thing. Then you have to write the observation table on the upper of this part. You have to write the observation table. Then you have to make this table. There will be this column reading, initial final difference, burette reading. Okay, burette reading. There you have to write in bracket CM cube. Burette reading in CM cube. That you have to, while writing the this experiment in the journal or say on the paper, you have to write burette reading in the CM cube. First, second, third, we are going to take the three readings. And out of that, we will see if the reading is coming constant. If the two readings are coming constant, then we will note here the CBR. If all these three readings are different, then we will take the MBR. Okay, you got MBR and the CBR. CBR is nothing but the constant burette reading. MBR is nothing but the main burette reading. Then similar way, we will go to take the reading for the second part. We will change the solution in the burette. In the solution of the, in the solution in the conical plus indicator endpoint, same table we are going to prepare. Okay. Then we will do the calculation, standardization of the supplied 0.08 normal NaOH solution. Succinic acid and NaOH is there. For the succinic acid, you can consider the N1V1, and for the NaOH, you can consider the N2V2. We have to calculate the concentration of the NaOH. That's why N2 we have taken here. You can see N2 is here. Then N2 is equal to N1V1 divided by V2. V2 is nothing but X, and that's why we know the N1 concentration of the succinic acid volume is also, we know, 0.1 into 10 divided by burette reading. That gives you the concentration of this first solution, 0.084 normal. Then you, similarly, you can calculate the concentration of the another solution by using N1V1 is equal to N3V3. Another solution of the NaOH is there. That's why we are labeled it as a N3V3. Okay, you can take N2V2 also. And then you can calculate the concentration of this particular. In the result, just simply you have to mention normality of the supplied 0.08 normal NaOH solution is that, and normality of the supplied 0.01 normal solution is that. Got this point? Here you can see the correction is there, 0.1 normal, not is a 0.01, it is a 0.1. Make the correction while writing in the journal. This is about the experiment number 1.